Hello, Facebook Ads people. I'm Konstantinos, and today we're going to talk about one of my favorite topics, branding in general and branding in Facebook. The reason why I'm doing this video is not, basically this video is not having any strategy about Facebook ads. We're going to talk about theory right now because I feel that sometimes people misunderstand some things. So I hear people that they're just starting their businesses and they talk about branding. You don't have a brand yet. Do you know what is a brand? A brand is a recognizable name, logo, whatever we might say. And this is when you are doing branding. When you are having a new store or you are having a store that it's not massive or whatever, you are not having a brand, you are trying to build a brand. It's completely different. And you cannot behave like a brand. You need first to become a brand and then you're going to behave like it. That being said, let's see some examples of branding. For example, my t-shirt over here. My t-shirt over here, it's a very simple t-shirt that I'm sure that most probably costs $5, but because it has this little small text over here, which is I think 2 centimeters, okay? For this reason, it might cost, I don't remember how much I bought it, but I'm guessing 75-80 euros, okay? This is branding. You are not paying for the t-shirt as an item, but you are paying for this name that is being put on this item. Also, I need to point out that branding doesn't mean that the item is going to be quality item. It means that you're just buying the brand, okay? The feeling that it has to wear a brand that someone can recognize you in the street and say, oh, this guy is wearing this or that. And you're not buying the actual item. This is what branding is, okay? The extra value that you're putting into an item. So if this item was simple without any stamp, it would be 5 euros. Now with a stamp is this. Branding is the extra thing that you put on a simple, ordinary item and you're making it an item of a brand, which is a family of a lifestyle and a way of living with this brand, okay? This is what is branding. Another example, let's talk about my channel, okay? And saying that, I want to thank my friends in Neon Marvel for making this sign for me. So here we have the thing that I say when I close my videos, be creative and be consistent. This is branding. I'm giving a branding and I'm saying that I'm closing all of my videos with that. This is my message, okay? So this can be branding. The fact that I have a method which is being called the crazy method and everybody's coming to the comments and they are saying, hey, every time you need my love. I use your crazy method and stuff and they like to use the term. This is a correct branding, okay? And it means that people actually understood that I wanted to give it a special name and the name was successful. The people like to use it, so my branding is successful. The fact that nobody is using the term MOB for my manual bidding, it means that my branding over there was a fail branding. The fact that nobody is using the simple method thing, it means that nobody liked this branding. So, that being said, your branding not only has to be good, it has to be accepted by the people. The people have to use it in order for it to be successful. The crazy method is a very good example for you to understand because all of my friends like to use the word crazy method, crazy method, crazy method, okay? It's catchy, okay? It's something that people like to use. By the way, for this neon sign, I will put a link in the description. Please go check their site. It came super fast and it's a very good quality and I'm very happy with it that I'm going to have it from now on in all of my videos. There is no code, by the way. I'm not going to win anything out of it. They're just one of my clients that we are running ads. If you want, you can go and you can check their products. Okay, I'm going to continue with examples of branding. So let's hear the sound. So, now that you hear the sound, you know who it is. This is branding. The whole concept about this guy and the voice, it's all about branding. It's something unique, recognizable. This is branding. And now, actually, let's watch the actual footage of Mr. Tarzan. One last example, just so that we can be clear. Just give me 1 second. Okay, so this is a package, and I'm not showing the actual brand. Some of you that you know the brand, you know immediately from this orange color, which is unique, which is the brand. And this is branding. Even understanding from the packaging of the products that this item, it's a specific brand. Okay, I'm not going to say which brand, just because I don't want to flex, okay? But those that who know the brand, they're going to understand. Okay, and just to give you a little bit more concept, this pattern over here that you see in this shoe, it's actually a very standard pattern that if you know the brand, you're going to understand immediately what brand it is, okay? So this is all about recognizability. There are brands like Burberry, for example, that they have a specific pattern, and you know them the moment that you're going to see them. There are brands like this that they have this pattern, and you know the moment that you're going to see them what kind of brand they are. So, just to conclude, this is branding. To actually wear something that costs 5 euros and you wear it because it's a brand, to actually recognize something from a distance just because it has a unique pattern and only this company can do that. Christian Louboutin has also high heels with this red bottom. And so many other things, so many other things. Branding, it's also when you're having a brand that it's easily recognizable and you can see it everywhere and you just want to wear it because it brings you another lifestyle and it's going to make you more desirable, for example, okay? So, all good with theory, okay? This is branding. Okay, Konstantinos, you explained it. What is branding? We know that we are a startup. We are not having this kind of appeal and so on. How can we get there? It's very simple. Consistency. You need to do this again and again and again. You need to become very big. You need to have trade channels. You need to have influencers that are going to support you and they are going to help you build this brandness. And you need to actually have a lot of sales. Some companies that they might be doing 1 million per year or 2 million per year, maybe they will never have strong branding, okay? And there are companies that they're going to do less than that and they will have very strong branding because they have a very concentrated niche and a lot of people that they are fanatic with their products and they are going to be even better. So it's all about how you see it and how you market it. For example, are you creating t-shirts and you're just putting a logo? Is your logo unique so that you can be a brand which is going to be recognizable? Or maybe you're putting t-shirts and instead of just putting a logo here or here, you're just putting your logo here. This is also branding. We know that North Face is putting all of their logos here. It's difference, okay? And it's showing that, you know, I'm doing something different, it's going to look unique and stuff. And this is what people are looking for, unique stuff. So when you're marketing your products, try to do products that are going to do different from the other people's products and so that you can show them that you're doing branding, okay? Because if you're just having a t-shirt with just a logo, this is not branding and you are never doing branding. But if you're doing branding in a different way, maybe you're doing branding, for example, into your packaging. I will never forget the moment I took my first Razer gaming mouse. It had a card inside and it was saying, "Welcome, now you are part of the Razer family, of the Razer gaming family." I felt so good. I felt like I was a part of a very big group of gamers or whatever, okay? This is branding. It makes you feel special. It tells you that the product that you took, it's a special thing and stuff. Anyway, all of these examples are here for you so that you can understand if you're doing or if you're not doing branding. And I want you to do branding. I want you to be able to brand your products, but you need to understand that you have to be unique. You have to be different. Even if you copy something, copy it with your own way and tweak it a little bit, okay? So that you can do your own branding. Other than that, if you're just another brand that is selling t-shirts and stuff, be fine. I'm fine also with it. You're not doing branding, you're going for massive sales. It's okay, it's also good. But at the end of the day, know that the extra value that we want, it's coming from branding. And because Facebook advertising is becoming more and more and more expensive, we need this extra value to come because it's going to help us be profitable with our ads. So that's all I had for branding. I really enjoyed this video. I hope you also liked it because I wanted to talk so much about branding and I had so many examples that I wanted to give you and share with you. So Tria apparently behind the camera doesn't like branding, as she told me 5 seconds ago. So if you want to learn more about Facebook ads like Soteria, you can check my book and my free course. And until we meet again, be creative and be consistent, guys.